get. Go get those stairs.
Fundamentally, the main program we're conducting is the dust mitigation, which are in reaction to lessons we learned on Exercise Safe Sharia in Oman 2 years ago. And fundamentally, we're going to give the performance of the air filters, which attracted quite a lot of publicity, an improvement by 5 times. Now, the armor package is one that we do for most deployments and is no different, less that we actually hang canvas skirts on the bottom of the vehicle, which are part of that dust mitigation package.
Moving north up a road, we've managed to cut off what appeared to be a convoy of military and civilian clothes escaping in trucks and vehicles. We engaged on what appeared to be their sentries, armed with rocket-propelled grenades and Kalashnikovs. Many of the convoy slipped away, difficult to tell if they're armed or not. Those who remained continued to engage us, and having destroyed their vehicles, we were able to pick off those few who had attempted to retreat into the civilian or into the housing area behind us.
I was reversing the driver, and all of a sudden I just saw the rocket propelled grenade coming towards me via the sight, so I kind of ducked down and it just exploded and took the periscopes out. This could be my last moments. There's having Everton rushing past in front of you. I think a lot of things that I've not done, but it has been quite a drama. But we scraped through. We came through with no casualties, so that's the main thing.
The guys in the back told me we'd been hit. I hadn't noticed. It seemed an RPG was fired just as we were getting past it, and it hit this back bin. That was Ben backing off a lot more, straight onto the back door. Which ricocheted off into the back, into the other bin. So. Gave us a lot of confidence about how solid these things are, especially because this is generally considered a weaker point, but very exciting.
The regime is being removed. I don't think the regime falls like a tree. There's still some more work to be done.
Deal with the hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people, thousands, who've come in here to loot, and they've been taking absolutely everything.
Iraqi population obviously it wanted revenge on Saddam, so they tried to steal a lot of things which they believed to be Saddam's property. We are now having to clamp down on that, and looters are being detained. I think we believe we can hold them up for up for 7 days, but in the absence of any sort of legal or judicial system, they won't be held for longer than that. We're more into the business of discouraging the looters than actually detaining them at the moment, but persistent offenders are being detained.
Yesterday there was an attack on two vehicles in Basra. One of the vehicles was destroyed. We sent in a quick reaction force to extract the personnel involved. There was a firefight that ensued. Unfortunately, one of our soldiers was killed and a number were injured. There was reports that the oil had stopped being produced. This was a lie. The manager of the Southern Oil Company was actually threatened, but he just carried on with production as normal. So, thankfully, at the moment, things are calm in Basra.